This time on Scrap Kings. A motorway bridge in Scotland suddenly collapses.
Draw back! Draw back!
All hopes and dreams of cruising around Britain in Bubblicious are crushed. And a care home is razed to the ground. But precious Roman remains lie just below the surface. Hamilton, South Lanarkshire, in the central lowlands of Scotland. The M74 motorway, running southeast out of Glasgow. A vital economic link between England and Scotland for bridge builder Stuart Baird.
That particular section of M74 was constructed in 1968.
Originally a largely single-track road, the new six-lane motorway helped drive the economy in the late 20th century. But recently, it's been creaking at the seams.
As the population of the commuter towns around Glasgow has grown, obviously the motorway has become much more used. It was designed for traffic flows around the 1990 level of about 85,000 vehicles a day. However, since 1990, traffic on the route has increased by 50%. That's resulted in sections requiring to be widened, and the works that are ongoing at the moment are increasing it from three lanes to four in each direction.
A new, much wider bridge has already been built, but the old Bothwell Road Bridge must be removed. A positive move for local resident Vincent McBreety.
It's necessary. You have to move with the times. You have to expand the motorway, get access in and out of Glasgow.
Okie doke. Thanks. Cheers.
Scrap King Alan Beattie must take her down.
2 years of planning comes down to one weekend, 56 hours.
It's a battle between man and a beast of engineering. On one side, she weighs 1,500 tons, is 14 metres tall and 110 metres long. The middle of the bridge will be cut out first, and the two end sections chipped away in a finely balanced demolition. On the other side, an army of 20 men and their mechanical brothers in arms. 8 43-ton excavators to reach up to the bridge, each driven by an 11-litre engine delivering 362 horsepower. And 2 47-ton excavators with an ultra-high reach. Tooled up with pecker hammers for destruction, grabbers to pull the bridge apart, and buckets to scoop up the rubble. There can only be one winner, but the ticking clock is the biggest enemy.
It's deadly critical that the road opens for 6 a.m. Monday morning to keep traffic flowing. There's not a lot of margin for error.
As Friday night falls, Commander-in-Chief Alan runs through the battle plan.
Davy has got the reach to come up more and do on it if you just pepper the beam.
Well, you should have got the easy bit tonight, Red.
With the strategy in place, the motorway must be shut.
We're getting southbound first, and then we'll get northbound. So by that time, I'm hoping to have at least an access road across into the centre that he can start peddling stuff here.
Work begins up top, but as the last car drives through below, it's now diggers only on the carriageway. All six lanes are theirs. The field of combat must be protected so that the cars can return on Monday morning. Rolls of fabric protect the tarmac. Steel plates spread the load of what's about to land on top.
Hey, come here!
Thousands more tons of hardcore will catch falling lumps of concrete and provide height to work from.
Up you go!
With road protection in place, battle can commence.
I'm just putting the last loads in, doing the protection. It's hammer time. We're good to go. I'm always better when I hear the hammers rattling.
High-reach excavators armed with a PECA drive take out the middle section first to keep the end sections balanced.
If we just cut a hole through it, it's got the potential with the cantilever to break fold in itself.
To stop the dust spreading, a mechanical water spray is fired towards the bridge.
20 minutes in, making good progress. The scrap's looking quite promising. I'm a happy man.
Alan's just the latest generation of a family that's been doing demolition for decades.
Traditionally, it is family-based. We're a tight-knit family and like working together.
The middle of the bridge must be taken down delicately to avoid an uncontrolled collapse.
It's turned rather cool. When I get an air gap through that centre section, we'll be happier. And then I could get all the excavators working on it.
But by 5 in the morning, she's proving stubborn. And with just 39 hours to go, Alan's not happy.
I had secretly hoped to be a wee bit further on at this stage, if I'm honest. The concrete's proven a bit tougher than we initially thought. It's taking a bit more breaking, so we just need to be careful that we don't cause an uncontrolled collapse here. We're taking our time working it down rather than it collapsing down.
It's a contest between hammers and 1,500 tonnes of reinforced concrete, unwilling to come down easily. They're already behind schedule, and Alan can only hope the demolition gods are smiling on him.